Ukraine has got a new pro-European majority, says our correspondent in Kiev, reporting on the opening of parliament. And Prime Minister Arseniy Yatsenyuk, as expected, kept his job. President Poroshenko proposed foreign experts join the government, the cabinet set to be formed next week. A show of unity, dispelling rumours of rivalry between Ukraine's leaders as parliament met for the first time since October's elections. The new Speaker of the House also got in on the act in a display scripted in part for the eyes of Moscow amid the bitter conflict with pro-Russian rebels. Looking to the future, we can clearly see that establishing peace in Donbass won't prevent danger from the east. Unfortunately, this danger will remain. It will require lots of our efforts and resources. Separately, the president suggested a foreigner should head Ukraine's new anti-corruption bureau. This as members formed a five-party coalition of support for the pro-Western leader, reappointed Arseniy Yatsenyuk as prime minister, and elected Ukraine's first Jewish parliamentary speaker. We need change to fight corruption, to decentralize governance, to provide economic growth, to make lots of things happen which we've been expecting to happen for dozens of years. Ukraine's big neighbor will have been watching. The Russian government's press service says Prime Minister Dmitry Medvedev and Prime Minister Yatsenyuk have spoken by telephone to discuss financial and economic relations between their two countries.